Hello and welcome to a slightly odd topic at A-level, talking about input and output devices, which is a little bit odd because I must confess, I teach this topic to my year sevens. So it's a little bit odd that it's included at A-level. So we'll see what we can do to make it sort of A-level standard, I suppose. Input devices provide data to a computer. So their primary aim is to give a computer some data. They plug into the computer or they're wireless and they provide it some input. So for example, a keyboard plugs into a computer, its primary aim is to provide data to the computer, namely what keys are being typed and for how long they're being held down and things like that. A mouse is used to control the cursor on screen, of course, and move it around. A barcode reader is able to scan barcodes and tell the computer which barcode has been scanned. A scanner is used to provide an electronic version of a paper-based document. A webcam takes in images and audio from the user and provides it to a computer. A graphics tablet provides what the user is drawing to the computer. Now, all of these are input devices. Their primary goal is to provide data to a computer. The computer can then process it and do other stuff with it. And it's a rare example of where someone like me would tell you not to think too much about this topic. Don't overthink any of these devices, because when you start to sort of pick apart some, you know, that definition, for example, you'll find issues. For instance, this keyboard here has got LED lighting. Most likely, this computer is controlling that LED lighting. It might be software on the computer allowing me to control what lighting is being shown and the colors. So therefore, some data has been provided to the keyboard. So it's not just a one-way process going from the keyboard to the computer. Some data is going back the other way. However, we don't overthink it. We are saying, generally speaking, a keyboard is an input device. And there is not a set list of input devices you have to learn. The way this will manifest itself in a question is you'll get some scenario and you'll be asked to either identify what input devices they are using, or you'll be asked to recommend some input device. And you might have to justify your answer. So for example, a graphic designer, what input device should they be using? Well, drawing stuff on a computer using a mouse could be quite tricky. Using a graphics tablet means it can better replicate real life, adds more control, things like that. So you have got to be able to justify and have enough examples in your head to be able to recommend given a scenario. So to help you do this, despite it not being absolutely necessary at A level, I want to give you some more slightly more technical ones which you could use in your answers. So here is a list of different sensors. A sensor is a device that measures properties in its environment. Usually automatically, it just sits there and is measuring something going on around it. That's what environment means in this context. So a thermistor is a heat sensor. It measures temperature. I've seen in Mark schemes, it doesn't like you to say thermometer, I think because the thermometer doesn't actually provide data to a computer. So you need to say either thermistor or heat sensor. This could be used in a kettle, so it knows when to stop heating up the water. It could be used in a jacuzzi. It could be used in a air conditioning unit so that it turns on the aircon after a certain temperature. A gyroscope is a sensor which measures orientation. So this might be used in a smartphone to measure whether you are in landscape mode or portrait mode, so the screen can adjust itself to your orientation. An accelerometer is really versatile. It can be used to do lots of things. What it actually does is measure acceleration, but you can use changes in acceleration to infer lots of different things. So it may provide acceleration data to the computer, but from that data, the computer will be able to do some processing and can determine stuff like how many steps you've taken with your smartwatch or your phone. It can determine whether you have fell over when you're walking. Perhaps with other sensors, it can help determine your speed, or at least how your speed is changing. An altimeter is measuring altitude, which is the distance above sea level. This would obviously need to be used in something like a plane for autopilot, but the altitude doesn't need to be thousands of feet like a plane would have. It could just be you on the ground level, determining whether you are running up a hill or running down a hill, or whether you're going upstairs or going downstairs. And there are lots of other sensors like pressure, light, humidity, force, vibration, which don't have fancy names, but learning some of the fancier names does, I think, help make this a slightly more A-level topic. Output devices, again, we're not going to think too hard about this because there are always edge cases. Output devices, generally speaking, receive data from a computer and often either show it to the user or do something with it in the environment. So here are four examples: monitors, projectors, printers, and speakers. We also can have slightly specific output devices for different scenarios. So for example, if I was having a jacuzzi, the jacuzzi might use a thermistor as the input device, and the output after some processing might be the heater turning on and heating the water to a higher temperature because the thermistor said it was too cold. Something like that, right? It can be quite specific. Here are some kind of computer related output devices. And again, just to attempt to make it a little bit more A-level, and you do see this mentioned in MART schemes, so I do think you should know it. Actuators are another type of output device. An actuator is a device that causes physical movement. So it's a massively broad category. Here is an actuator which is rotating around. The computer gives it a signal and it's outputting this movement really to rotate this circle around. This one here could be used in a pipe to stop water traveling. So it's like a valve. And when you move it, water flows through and continues. This one here is what you might call a linear actuator. This GIF shows the motor, which is really driving the movement in actuators. This could be used for a locking mechanism in a door. This one here is another rotation actuator, which doesn't rotate fully around. It's just a set range. This could be used maybe for, I don't know, a CCTV camera to rotate around a certain radius. And this last one here, you may not be able to make it up perfectly, but is a spinning disc. You can see it says the word servo on it. A servo is another word for an actuator. You often hear the word servo with people who are making robots and things like that. It's just another word for an actuator. This one here, spinning around, may be used for a fan or something like that. So circuits often have actuators in when we want some movement. They are output devices because the computer is sending a signal to this actuator, and the actuator is doing something based on the signal. That is what makes it an output device.